tight to your center. So you don't thrust and create a gap here. You thrust and tight to your center. And you're far more connected. And you feel the back foot, the back hip is locked, and you're much stronger. Right. A few things. If I use this line, my back foot is at 45 degrees. This way. It doesn't start at 90 degrees. 45 degrees, my front foot is on the plan. If I'm next to it, it's on the other side. It's not going to be zero. So it's often the foot straight, pointing straight. Skinukamei requires the moving of your hips. That means you grip the jaw with your little finger very firmly. And it stays firm when you do the thrust. It doesn't do that. And then thrust. I exaggerate a little bit. What we don't want to see happening is when you're into Skinukamei is you bring the jaw too far back. Because when you bring the jaw too far back, you're going weak here. If someone was facing you too far back, you block your arm. But if it's just enough, you still go forward. So the hand does not do that. The hand goes forward. So it's this hand doing this motion, not that motion. This motion. Is get a feel, this is a jaw. My body is going under the jaw. So if I'm going on this side, it's the same thing. But I don't thrust with, you know, being above the jaw. Above the jaw elevates my body. If I'm under the jaw, it's grinding me even more. So sink down more.